I'm here with Mayor Mike Coffman. I want people to know there's 400 or 500 appointments available today at the Aurora Municipal Center vaccination site. You can even show up without an appointment. Across Colorado, there's folks who are saying, look, the pharmacy I use, they're booked up for 2 weeks. I can't get my booster. And that may be true of particular pharmacies. That's why we have a number of larger vaccination sites that have plenty of capacity. We could be doing 50%, even double the number of vaccinations every day with the sites we have, and one of them right here at the Aurora Municipal Center vaccination site. Before we begin, just a moment of reflection. Here in Colorado, we've lost over 10,000 people to COVID-19 nationally, over 800,000 people that are no longer with us, mothers, fathers, aunts, uncles, sisters, and brothers. Our rate in Colorado in hospitalizations continues to go down. I'm happy to report that it went down by 43. That still means that there's 1,227 Coloradans in the hospital for COVID right now. Only 14% of those are vaccinated. That's right, only 176 people out of the 1,227 are unvaccinated. Many of those are older with pre-existing conditions, but there's over 1,000 people who are unvaccinated who've been hospitalized. So if you haven't made the decision yet, please get protected, get vaccinated. And most of the folks coming through these sites are getting their booster, which is even more important than ever before because of the Omicron variant. The initial data shows that 3 vaccinations are necessary to have a high level of protection against Omicron. And I'm excited that by mid-February, we gave more than 70% of Coloradans 70 and up the protection they deserve. We met the national goal of 70% of adults vaccinated by July 4th. And today, we're at 81% of Coloradans 12 and up who've gotten their first dose. Of course, we've also begun with 5 to 11-year-olds. We're in the top 10 in the country with 26% of 5 to 11-year-olds having gotten their first dose. I encourage my fellow parents to get their kids protected. My 10-year-old and 7-year-old are thrilled that they have that level of protection. You know, we're fortunate to have these safe and effective vaccines. And, you know, we now face a new threat with the Omicron variant. We have 5 cases of Omicron confirmed, but it's only a matter of time till it becomes the prevalent variant here in Colorado, as it has in every other place it's been. We also have identified what we believe to be the first case of community spread here in Colorado. What do we know? We know that vaccination and boosters work to protect people against Omicron. We also know that the 2 vaccinations is not enough to have a high level of protection against Omicron. The life of every Coloradan matters. Boosted Coloradans are 47 times less likely to be hospitalized than unvaccinated Coloradans. That's why sites like this in Aurora are so important. Many Coloradans have turned to their local pharmacy to get a booster dose, and they found they might have to wait a week or two to get an appointment. But we don't want you to have to wait. We want to make sure you have that protection by Christmas and New Year's. That's why we have 9 community sites across the state with available appointments every day. And you can also just show up without an appointment and get vaccinated. I want to turn it over to Aurora Mayor Mike Coffman, who's been a leader in encouraging Aurora residents to get protected.
Thank you, Governor. I agree with the governor that it is very important for all those who are eligible to be vaccinated. It's to help protect yourself, to help protect your family, to help protect your coworkers, and to help protect our community. Me acuerdo, estoy de acuerdo con el gobernador en que es muy importante que todos los elegibles se vacunen, ayudar. A protegerse, ayudar a proteger a su familia, ayudar a proteger a sus compañeros de trabajo y ayudar a nuestra comunidad.
¿Tú hablas español bien, señor alcalde?
Y también soy de acuerdo que es la cosa más importante para proteger su propia y su familia. El vacuna es muy efectivo, es seguro, es totalmente gratis en muchos sitios en todo el estado, incluido el Aurora Municipal Center aquí. Y es muy fácil recibirlo y es más importante para el variante Omicron que ya está en Colorado.
Thank you, Mayor Coffman. This site here is open Monday through Thursday and also Friday through Sunday. So it's open all week, 7 days. The hours Monday through Saturday are 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. So you can come after work or during lunch break. Sunday, 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. That's the Aurora Municipal Center. There are sites and doses available. Ball Arena, Saturday, the December 18th, Thursday, December 23rd. That one's only open at certain times. This one's open all the time. We also have the Arapo Community College, Lot B in Littleton. That's 5900 South Santa Fe, 7 days a week. Monday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Sunday, 11 to 4. Chapel Hills Mall in Colorado Springs, 7 days a week, 10 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Just stop by in Colorado Springs, get vaccinated. Citadel Mall in Colorado Springs next to JCPenney, Monday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Douglas County Fairgrounds in Castle Rock, that's 500 Fairgrounds Road. That's open 7 days a week. That's Monday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Sunday, 11 to 4. In Littleton, Jefferson Marketplace, it's on South Kipling Parkway, Tuesday through Sunday, 9 a.m. to 6:45 p.m., so a little bit later after work if you work near Littleton or live near Littleton. In Grand Junction, Mesa County Community Service Building, Wednesday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 5, and Saturday, 9 a.m. to 1. Durango, La Plata Fairgrounds on Main Avenue, 9 a.m. to 3:30, Monday through Saturday. Pueblo Mall, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. Tuesday through Sunday, available every day. In Greeley, Weld County Clerk and Recorder Building, Tuesday through Thursday, 8:30 to 6. Wednesday, it ends a little earlier, 4:30, but Saturday it's open 8:30 to 12:30. So Saturday morning it's also open. There's a lot of other sites across the state. You might also have availability at your local pharmacy, but if you don't for a week or two, don't wait. Get boosted. Omicron is coming. The booster works. You need to have three courses of the vaccine to have a high level of protection against the booster. You can go to covid19.colorado.gov/vaccine to find out where that's available near you. The booster is the best way to make sure that Colorado and you and your family are prepared for Omicron. That added layer of protection is critical. It's also especially critical as you travel, if you plan travel over the holiday season, a ski vacation, plan to visit family in other parts of the country, make sure that you can be protected. So remember, get protected, get boosted, wear a mask indoors around others. And with that, we're happy to take questions. Yes.
Sí.
Ahora la ciencia dice que el variante Omicron se necesita la vacuna de refuerzo. Es importante recibir tres vacunas para proteger a su propia y su familia contra el variante Omicron, que ya está en Colorado y va a ser el variante más popular muy pronto porque es más peligroso.
Bueno, ahora para mi segunda pregunta es su reacción sobre la sentencia de Rafael Mederos y si ya llegó a su oficina esa petición que más de 1 millón de personas han firmado, ¿qué es lo que piensa al respecto?
This is a reaction to which, what petition is that?
Rafael Mederos sentencing.
Yeah. Ya, voy a leerlo y estudiarlo y preparar una respuesta. Yeah, there is increased urgency to get the third vaccine because from the preliminary data that has been presented to me, having three vaccines is absolutely critical to have a high level of protection against the Omicron variant. We're ninth in the country in percentage of our population boosted, but our whole country is lagging behind a number of other countries in getting people successfully boosted. So my main message is, if it's been 6 months, get the third vaccine. You need it for protection against the Delta variant, which wanes over time, but even more importantly, against the new variants that are already here in Colorado. The ongoing pandemic remains a threat over time as we have addressed the supply issues around masks and gowns. Testing is available for free to every Colorado resident. Vaccines are available for free to every Colorado resident. We've also expanded monoclonal antibody treatment and our ability to deliver monoclonal antibody treatment, which reduces the hospitalization rate by 70%, currently exceeds the demand for that treatment. So if you have contracted COVID recently, please consider getting monoclonal antibody treatment at any of our mobile monoclonal treatment stations or at a hospital or clinic near you.
With the message coming from the hospitals that there is an emergency there with overloading and for hospital beds, is that not an emergency that the state needs to be determined?
Well, we're certainly in a better place than we were a couple weeks ago. We have 300 or 400 people less hospitalized. We also acted early on to build additional hospital capacity, and we brought on board some of those beds. We have others that are planned as contingency if needed to make sure that we don't exceed our hospital capacity and the ability to care for every Coloradan in need of medical attention, whether it's COVID or some other condition.
Two quick follow-ups to some of the questions that were already asked. When you said the comment about not being a medical emergency anymore, are you speaking from more of a policy standpoint?
Well, you know, when COVID hit, it was an emergency of drastic proportions. You all might recall we had in our hospitals no masks, no gloves, no gowns. We didn't have treatments for people. That was in March of 2020. We're in a very different spot today. COVID remains a threat, but we now have highly effective vaccines that can all but eliminate deaths and significantly reduce hospitalizations. They're available to anybody who wants them. We have plenty of supplies, masks, gloves. We've been sending masks to teachers and schools who want them for many months. We have free testing available for every Coloradan. We also have treatments, and that's the monoclonal antibodies that show great success. It's important that people get them before they need hospitalization. That's for after you are diagnosed with COVID in that first week. It prevents the mild to moderate cases from turning severe. And for those cases that do sort of turn severe and are hospitalized, there are other treatments like steroids available. They're not as effective as monoclonal antibodies, and to be clear, nothing as effective as the vaccine. So we're in a very different place today, and it doesn't mean that there still isn't a deadly virus among us. There very much is. But we have a lot of tools, and we want to make sure people have the right information to protect themselves and their family. And the best decision that they can make is to get vaccinated and boosted. Yeah. We review all clemency applications. We've yet to receive one from the individual, but every clemency application that we receive, we review and make a determination. Yeah? Any others?
Thank you, Governor, for coming
Thank you.
Out.
It's great to be in Aurora. Get protected. Get vaccinated.